It's Anglo-Saxon. It's Bulgarian LARP, for example, it's Anglo-Saxon. Germans get Anglo-Saxon LARP. Some of Polish LARPs are Anglo-Saxon. It's the games which are focused on entertainment or having fun. It's mostly gamistic or simulationist. Of course, it depends on the game, but mostly it's gamistic, so you could want something, you could achieve something, you could get a group of friends or a team and achieve something together. So there's a really big thing to get a team, to get a teamwork. Also, there's a popular fighting with buffers. The whole name, Anglo-Saxon game, is created by Nordics, about Nordics in a way, about by Nordics for making a district distance between Nordic LARPing and Anglo-Saxon, because there's the tradition. Mostly Anglo-Saxon LARPs goes in fantasy settings or in popular settings like Lord of the Rings, Warhammer, and so on. There's a lot of scenography and props. This LARP could be very good at visual aspects, very
impressive.
Very impressive. Yeah, sorry for my English. Costumes are common. Also, there's most of Anglo-Saxon games are outdoor games, so we're playing outside, and it takes a bigger amount of people. So it's more than 20 normally. The biggest club, Germans club, got Germans, they got few thousand players playing at the same time. And it's also a Dragon Fest or
something.
Yeah, of the gear. Sandbox is a common tool. Sandbox means, as a design, that everyone goes to the place of where we're LARPing. And everyone gets their own character, which are not preparing with Game Master, but by yourself. Or preparing with Game Master, but without a storyline, the strict storyline, during the game. So your character is put into some environment, and you are having fun because you are in the world. So more or less, this is the sandbox. And sandbox is a common tool for Anglo-Saxon. Also, the games here are bigger and non-transparent. You don't know what will happen in a minute. You don't know what happened to your character. You get fun because of the mysteries, because you don't know, you are not sure what will happen. So this is the part of Anglo-Saxon. If there will be any kind of question during the collection, just ask, because I know that for me some questions, some text and some descriptions are normal, but I know it's not normal, so please ask me. Then we've got Nordics. Nordics are this type of LARP which is based on Knutpunkt conference. It's the biggest LARP conference, which is based in Scandinavia. Each year it's in a different country of Scandinavia. It's also known as a Solmkohta conference, it's the same. And at Knutpunkt, designers find out style, tradition, called Nordic LARPs. Nordic LARPs are different than Anglo-Saxon because it's based on storyline and on the narrative. They don't care that much about props, costumes, they don't care that much about winning something or achieving something, but sometimes they have even something that they call play to lose, which means that they play to lose or losing without accident. They just going for losing something in the game because it helps them making a storyline. There's a lot of crying. If we going by stereotypes, it's a lot of crying. Playing for storyline, there's a lot of immersion. Immersion is this moment when you feel like a character, that you stop remembering that you're, an example, Poundage or Urszula, and be a character for a minute, for an hour, for a whole day. It's exactly like in the theater, or when you watch a really interesting movie and you stop thinking about that you are watching the movie, you are in the storyline. So it's immersion. So they are really into immersion. They really care about artistic vision. Common tool as here is sandwich, is workshop and briefing the briefing. So preparing players to the game and show, give them a lot of new skills to playing the game, for being sure that everyone are the same level of knowledge. There's sometimes they use illusion as a scenography, but only for helping immersion, for helping feeling the world, feeling emotions. Because Nordics are based on Knutpunkt conference, there's a lot of debates and analysis. There's a lot of academic discussions. Sometimes it's totally not worth to read. Sometimes it's really nice because it's based on practice. And there's a lot of books that you could find on the internet freely because they are open source. I've got a lot with me, so if anyone of you wanna take them from me, it's okay. I would arrange that. And they produce a lot of different books, articles, and so on. So it's well known. Anglo-Saxon don't prepare that much articles, so you cannot read or knew how Anglo-Saxon LARPs works since you didn't go there mostly. And the common thing is that the games there are smaller. An example for even two persons, or 5 or 10 or 15, but not around 15. It's not this scale. And the common thing is transparency. You knew what would happen. I was even on some events when we get a schedule. What happened next? So you play from scene to scene and you're having fun because you create a storyline.